We'll make a wireless Lamborghini Aventador mouse, but for that, take some inspiration from a real-life Aventador. So I start by opening up a wireless mouse that I had lying around.
And if you've watched any of my previous video, you know what's gonna happen next.
Open Fusion to actually design the model. We can take help from a real-world image and continue with our design. It's starting to take shape and the internals are also quite developed now.
Let's 3D print this.
The first few prototypes are looking very promising. And finally, after countless prints, which I'll get to in a second, we are finally ready with the final prints that we'll be using in the real mouse.
So these are all of the prints that I had to go through in order to get this.
The original design was way flatter, and so it didn't have enough room to house all the components, but then we expanded it, and I'm finally happy with the final design. Anyway, with design sorted out, let's move on to the electronics, assemble it, solder everything together, and it should just work. For it to work, you actually have to attach this 2.4 GHz receiver to a dongle, and it's time to test it out. But first, turn it on, and we can see it just glides through like a normal mouse, which is, well, exactly what we're hoping for. The icing on the cake is, of course, that it's Type-C, so you have hassle-free charging, and it also passes the click test, which is very satisfying. It can just open easily, and you can see the internals, but it looks more like a Tesla Model Y than a Lambo, so let's start over. This time around, the donor mouse was way slimmer, so that it looks much more real. Let's take advantage of this form and hop onto, you guessed it, Fusion 360. This profile is a bit wider and shorter than last time, so it looks like a real Aventador. 3D prints turned out great, I couldn't be happier. Tweak the base and finally print that as well. Alright, this is the very first prototype that I got my hands on and it looks very promising. We can do a quick test fit by putting in all of the electronics in place, but we find out the left mouse click doesn't really work, so we'll just have to tweak that in the next one. Other than that, we're good to go. So finally, these are all of the versions that I had to go through. Surely less attempts compared to the Tesla mouse because I got the hang of it, and it's now time to work on the electronics part, do the required connections, and solder all the components. This turned out to be better than I expected. Even this one has Type-C charging and a red LED indicates that it's charging. This has Bluetooth and Wi-Fi both, so it can connect with up to 3 devices at a time. Once it's connected via Bluetooth, you can actually just use it like any other mouse. It works flawlessly, everything works along with the scroll wheel, and I'm pretty satisfied with the overall build.